President Biden is heading back stateside after a week-long family vacation in St. Croix. ABC News Alex Brochet has been covering the president from St. Croix and joins us now live. And I already know, Alex, everyone's been giving you a hard time about this beautiful place to be covering the president, so I won't even go there, even though the background's amazing and I'm loving your shirt. But President Biden returns to a Republican-led house in Washington now, right? His first ever big event this week is bipartisan with someone you might not expect. So break it all down from the beach, will you?
Kira, I'll do my best. So, yes, the president this week is going to be headed to the greater Cincinnati area to tout infrastructure projects in Kentucky and Ohio. And, you know, this kind of capitalizes on a message that he had for New Year's, saying that he was optimistic for this country in this new year. He's going to be joined by lawmakers, including Senate Minority Leader Mitch McConnell and also Ohio's Republican Governor Mike DeWine. And this is really important, Kira, because obviously the composition of Congress is going to be different with this incoming Congress, this incoming House being Republican controlled. The Biden administration is trying to build momentum off the jump to say that, hey, there's still room for bipartisanship going forward.
Well, talk to us more about this and what the White House is saying about how it is going to deal with the new Congress.
Well, so certainly this trip and the optics of it, right, being with Mitch McConnell and also Republican Governor Mike DeWine sets a tone. But I think while the Biden administration has been steadfast in saying that, like, we're willing to work with both Democrats and Republicans, a lot of these big sweeping wins that Democrats had during the first 2 years of his time in office, there's not going to be as much of an appetite to pass some of these sweeping legislations through Congress. And so, you know, where this bipartisanship lands, I mean, I think infrastructure is definitely something that's brought everybody to the table. But, you know, they're going to have to be, you know, different expectations here. I think, you know, one other thing that the White House is waiting to see how it shakes out is the leadership within that Republican-controlled House. Obviously, the third is going to be a big day for Republicans there. But while there is a relationship with Leader Kevin McCarthy, there are already members of this incoming Republican House that are looking to launch more investigations into the withdrawal from Afghanistan, also Hunter Biden's business dealings. The president has already said that he thinks that Congress should be working to do more to get things done and less investigating. But all that could impact what room there is for bipartisanship going forward.
So the president does say that he will have a clearer idea in the new year on the prospect of a 2024 presidential run. So do you think we could expect any kind of announcement soon?
Well, Kira, it's kind of funny. So Friday, the press saw the president leaving a restaurant, and he was asked about this. Was running in 2024, and he kind of joked, oh, I didn't know there was an election going on. But what we've heard from the White House, specifically from White House Chief of Staff Ron Klain, is that, yes, this is a vacation for the Bidens. It's a time to dine. It's a time to play some golf. But it was also an opportunity for him to talk with his family about the viability of a 2024 run. Ron Klain also saying, though, that he expected a decision to be made shortly after the holidays and that the decision would be to run.
All right, stay tuned. So, Alex, you think we can get you to come back home? It's pretty beautiful there.
Listen, Kira, I'm lobbying to set up a bureau here. I'd be happy. It's a burden that I'd be willing to bear.
Oh, you would do so well, too. I don't blame you. It would be a fun St. Croix bureau, ABC bureau. Alex Brochet, I'll ask around, see what I can do. Hopefully we'll see you soon, though.
Appreciate that.
Thanks, Alex.
Yeah.